just my eyes, the frozen skies. I know I chose my path. What's the cause for secrets lost? There's no turning back. Pull me under, show your teeth. We'll never be the same. There's ice in my veins. Dreams, my heartbeat starts to slow. I swore I'd find what's left behind. The answer's deep below. Pull me under, show your teeth. We'll never be the same. There's ice in my veins.
Welcome to BYDE's Don't Ever Frostbite Event. We have a big match starting the night off.
Gotta say a change today. Introducing first, Rhea Silver.
This match is an Aztec title match. Like a king of Farnies. A rematch, a year in the making. Based off in the latter part of last year for the United States Championship. And now, I've been rooting for the Aztec title. But finally, Silver was one-on-one with the United for the championship. They have won a number contenders match last month. Didn't get it one-on-one. Was not pinned in that match.
And introducing next.
Look at this.
He is the Aztec champion, Leonidas.
So tonight, Leonidas will have to try to actually pin Silver to retain the championship. If he gets disqualified, he loses. Aztec championship, a part of the rules of it being a fighting champion. We'll walk home with that belt.
You ready?
Yeah.
Ring the bell!
Just look how dressed up that roughly is. It's a cold day here. But it could impact things. Starting off with some changing of the horse, pushing off, going up and over. Now, what else could we have expected? But Silver can bring a high pace intensity to the beginning of Frostbite. Really nice, caught the kick. Now looking at the damage to the leg.
You want to submit?
But now mixed with the court to really impact Silver's high pace offense. Now, baseline was going after
him. One, two,
almost
two.
Won the match. I'm just saying, Leonidas was very smart to play sleeper hold before the impact of the breathing. We'll make the first move. Going for the leg of Leonidas now. And attacking all parts of the body.
One, two,
nice, nice roll.
Two,
both coming close to taking the victory. Hustling, Silver goes. Knee straight into the back. Silver took too much time catching the buff. Leonidas was able to gain momentum back into his favor.
One, two,
but it didn't
two,
get
it.
The victory.
One more time.
One, two, two.
I just need to focus on doing more damage, not just trying to win the match. Taking Silver up though. Silver wants none of it. And there's so many big matches here tonight. We still have, big drop kick. We still have a last man standing. Lord, Parker tiny little match. A false kind of little match between Prince.
Hey, get back in the ring. Yeah. Catch you out.
And the falling back. Nice baseball by Lee Knight. And catching his breath.
One.
And that was close to leg. Doing more damage to it.
Two.
We see a big tag team title match. Lord,
come on, get back in here.
Match.
I'll take my time!
Thank you very much, ref!
Four!
Very nice. Get back into the ring.
Five! Let's
see Silver's tag on though. Defend their intercontinental title against Bobby J, but no one! Boom! Again, using Lee Knight's speed against him. Planting him straight on his face. The Aztec title has been a championship to watch since being introduced in August. And since September, Leonidas was trying to be part of that picture. So you can only imagine what it would do if you lost the championship.
One,
tonight,
two,
you put so much focus in trying to win that belt, trying to keep that belt. If he was to lose it, he would be so pissed off at Silver. Too much time fixing the knee pad. At the moment, Terry. Stop! We got Lee and Ice back in the action. He hurt himself. He thinks he's burning him. And now, going even more with that bigger elbow. But that wasn't able to pick up a win here tonight. Speaking of picking up, you can hear the wind picking up. Call it frostbite for a reason. Elbow across the face. But Silver was able to get the boot up and get into the gut. You see, Silver is a foot block, but he's gonna put all of their force into those hits that they can. Had to hold on to up just to stand up a little bit. Go for it! U-D-E-T! Around the damn world! Climbing all the way to the top. Huge frog splash.
One, two,
Give him what you need, damage.
Do you want to submit?
With Lee Knight,
do you want to
tap
submit?
Out and give up the Aztec title. The bigger, the vertical base, the longer legs was able to get the advantage right there and make it easier to break the sharpshooter. Now doing a lot of damage, numerous elbows straight to the face. Another big slam, this is all she wrote.
One, two,
target,
two.
There wasn't much behind that kick up, but it was a kick up and the match continues. Silver is not gonna give up that easily. Going for the fall. Oh, the end of the match. Going for the final notice. Leonidas, match it up.
One, two.
Silva's stealing it. Despite the momentary Pokeball being crushed, Silva ain't giving up. Leonidas flying. But no, buddy. Silva, at the last second, barely getting away. Elbow of their own. What does Silva have in mind? Climbing the ropes again. Use the glove, I believe, as a way to kind of distract Silva. It's not Phil, but by technicality, it's legal. Going across the knee.
One.
Two! Really nice. Needs to make sure not to bend the rules too much. Pulling loose attack to get himself disqualified.
Already!
But you know, that's what he did to pick up the win at full of a damn.
One! Two!
Two!
And he's crushing Silva down with the knee as Silva was trying to get up. Go for one!
One! Two!
Barely kicking out!
Two!
Silva almost won the Aztec Championship! Straight to the chest! Now Silva has an opening! Wrecking ball! Drop kick!
Get back in the ring, guys! One!
Now go for O'Neal!
Two!
Sword! Planting the face straight into the ground!
Three!
Two might have won the match, making it Leonidas into the ring!
Four!
And now Jonas. Get Leonidas up. We can see it's already fading. He's already trying to catch his butt. Wait. Oh, dude! Four of them off the top!
One, two, three. Ring the bell!
Yes!
Shit!
Give me my title, ref!
Here's your winner!
Leonidas!
It
was huge Silva!
What everyone deserves! Leonidas!
Holy shit, that desperation move pulls off the victory here tonight!
Out of my rankings, this title!
What a damn way to start the night! Nice victory!
Here comes.
We move on to the last man standing match. Nuvom has one chance to rectify his mistake. Last year at Frostbite, Nuvom secretly made his debut, replacing the Fallen mid-match, costing him the victory against Twitch's Jester for the World Hardcore Championship. Since then, Nuvom has made a run with the Fallen, but has fallen again out of his good graces, and now it is forced for title match. A year later, he looks to win the World Hardcore title, but not to keep it for himself, but to give to the Fallen and reform Blood Ritual. Can the Reaper take the championship against this man? Right here, where he does not need to be pinned to lose the championship. He needs to be kept down. A two-time hardcore champion, Twisted Jester, back on top. But Vinny retained against a focused new bomb. Both have traded some verbal blows, some physical blows, and both have tied a little bit of mind games, but Nuvam is definitely more than ahead of Twisted Jester, playing off of Twisted Jester's tendency to get angry. But when it's go time, Twisted Jester can definitely get focused.
Okay, you two, back it up, back it up. Fall match is scheduled for Wood. Actually, it's not even scheduled for 1-4. It is actually a ball. Stardust. It is a last man standing match. Sorry, I was told about doing this reffing thing last minute. In this corner, we have the challenger, Nuvam, Kiana Vex. But he will not be taking the title. He's going to give it to the Fallen. So, you're a good man. In this corner, we have the current champion, Twisted Jester.
Bobby Wong. Nuvam already approaching to just put down the title. And Nuvam trying to get a little cocky. Trying to get in the head and, of course, angling Twisted Jester. But now, giving him a choke, Twisted Jester. A little bit more experience ring wise, getting out of the choke and now taking Nuvam down. Taking his time methodically, pacing around. Straight over his own knee. Already holding the vertical base of Nuvam and holding the power game, picking him up. Twisted Jester slowing down this match. Trying to stay calm, stay steady, and stay on the offensive. Thinking before every move he makes, but if he does things like that,
come on,
getting too cocky, it's going to cost him the title. Big shot to Jester from Nuvam. And going to the end. To the champion. And all you got in the first round of the match. Ooh, fell straight to the back of the head. Having to use the ropes to stand, he's clawing now. A shot like that literally rings no bell. Holding the back of the head. Ooh. And now they're waiting a moment to get into the ring, only hitting him. Now, Nuvam being a little bit cocky.
One. Two. Okay, he's to his feet.
What does Nuvam have in mind? Jumping off straight to the ribs with that shot. Just retreating a bit. Putting it over his head. Nuvam turns forward. Ooh. He just to manage to get up in time. And that damaged leg that he already hit, causing Nuvam to fall back, holding himself. Just holding the chair in front of him, and now holding it into the neck and chest of Nuvam. He needs to not get too cocky in this matchup. Ooh. When you're doing damage like that, you can kind of see why Jester would be cocky.
One.
He's been here.
Two.
He's defended titles at Frostbite.
Three.
He's faced a Reaper before.
Four. He's made it to his feet.
Nuvam's first count against him of the match. Woody up to four, almost halfway there. He's trying to score away, but not getting out of the ring. Interesting placement of the chair. Lining him up now.
Ooh! Heavy shot! One. Two. He's made it to his feet.
Very small in his first boxing match, already using the ring towards his advantage to get to his feet. Oh! And he used just his own momentum, own speed against him, quickly putting up the chair as a defensive block. They can do damage to himself in a big boot. Devon with a big staff in hand. We're gonna keep the damage. Hitting big shots to the low back. Now choking. Ouch. Twisted gesture.
One.
No.
Two.
Don't use the weight. Can heal that one straight to the ribs.
One.
That's not a pleasant
two.
Sound. That's not a pleasant
three.
Sound.
Three.
Knocking out his own demo and hitting it so hard.
Hey.
Ivan looking for another weapon. But I don't think he saw that. Twisted yet to realize he's very close to some extra wing tools that we have laying around. Ooh! And jabbing him with it. Straight to the neck. Now trying to break the eye hole of his mask.
One. Two.
Look how much pain Nuvom is in.
Three.
Oh dear God. A callback to the match is a frostbite pass with the saw. And he's trying. He's trying to reverse it. And in, now the mind games are in not in Nuvom's favor. Nuvom looks a bit psyched, but quickly making the offensive. Stop looking at the soul, Nuvom. If you want to win this match, you gotta stay focused. The mind games clearly working, but Nuvom is trying to stay focused.
One. Two.
I think Nuvom was on the saw a little bit again.
Four.
We're not gonna use it. Barely pulled it away in time. Ugh. Pulling against Nuvom's head a little bit. Not seeing a mortal person do something like that. That's something you see a damn Leaper do. But the chain being brought into many matches between Jester and the Fallen now being used. And I think that's something that Nuvom may not have had before here tonight. As he does damage to the base and neck of Jester. Ooh. That Jester definitely feels pain. But he likes it. It may cause his mouth to bleed a little bit, but he wants to put it in his mouth. He likes psyching out his opponent, even if he does damage to himself and doing a damage to himself, Nuvom. Doing damage to himself to take out Twisted Jester. Now, with his own barbed wire bat, straight to the back again.
One.
The homage to the Fallen. Reminding him
one.
Who he's doing this for.
Two. Three. Four.
And using the underpart of the ring to get up. Ooh. Caught the big boot. And again doing damage to the leg. But just have in mind. Ooh. Straight to the face.
One.
Nuvom looks absolutely
two.
Locked.
Three. Four. Five.
Come on, beat.
The highest count of the match so far that I'm aware of. And now again, trying to break the max in Nuvom by shoving the eye straight into the corner of the stirrups. Ooh, and straight onto the stirrups again. Face force hitting hard. Was going for a weapon, I bet he thinks he sees something else he likes. the ball of nails we saw we used a little bit in the past. Ooh, straight to the head. Not a pleasant feeling. Ooh, straight to the neck now. A low blow out of desperation. But Nirvam is barely moving. Ooh! And a move out of desperation. Nirvam is trying to get some distance.
Two!
As Jesse recovers from the low blow.
Three!
Nirvam having enough time to bounce the momentum once again.
Happy you. Tarway was not ended by that bucket.
Ooh, straight to the ribs. Using the bucket. Ooh, straight onto the head. An act of desperation.
Two.
Almost taking himself out.
Three.
And I think Nirvam fell yet onto the ball. Yes. I don't even think that was intentional.
Five. He's to his feet.
And just not able to capitalize very much off of that move. That act of desperation, the headbutting him. Big spear! Oh, taking himself out in the process. Just to clearly didn't see what was behind him. He bumps it up.
One.
So just his pants.
Two.
In his first title feud for the hardcore title. With then champion Blue Spade versus Twitch Adjuster. Twitch Adjuster would kidnap Greenie. And despite not winning it the first time around, in a rematch, would take the championship. But big damage has been done
one.
To Nirvam. And Adjuster might have just won the match.
Two.
He may be
wearing
a max on his face, but you can tell he's in pain.
Four. Five. Six. Seven.
Up to seven.
To his feet.
Barely to his feet, but he's to his feet. Nirvam is putting on a show here tonight, not giving in. Ooh, putting the arm in an unpleasant way, and now the other arm. Ooh! Now take off the protective padding. What does Twitch Adjuster have in mind here? Oh, dear God. What does Twitch Adjuster looking for, trying to grab the hammer? Used, ooh, and hitting it towards his fingers. I have no idea on Nirvam. Ooh! I was gonna say, I did not know how Nirvam was gonna get out of that.
One.
Well, desperation using the bow.
Two.
Nirvam.
Three.
Found an opening and locked. Twitch Adjuster again. But you can clearly see he's feeling it
five,
in his hand. The damage was
six,
done.
Seven.
Oh, DDT! Bending straight.
One.
Onto the box. The dog carrier.
Two.
But look, Nirvam has removed his glove.
Three.
Definitely showing signs of being injured.
Four. Five.
Wait, what does Nirvam have in mind?
Six.
Nirvam up on the apron. Oh! Breaking the dog crate. Ooh, and a big boot! Straight to the side edge! Now trying to grab some weapons from inside! Nirvam has gained momentum in this matchup!
Two!
Another move of desperation to destroy this matchup! Ooh, going for the leg that he targeted early on in the matchup! Proving dividends in the long game. Hey, what does... Ooh! Rusty, what does Jess have in his hand? Oh, another low blow with the steel. even more foot to the time. And Yvonne saw that what he has in his hand, some sort of pun. Ooh! And grabbing just in the face with a pun.
One. Two.
Just a
three.
Really showing the signs of a hard fight.
Four.
War Hulk or Tyler
Mack. Six.
Two people fighting out.
Seven.
For a championship. And barely to his feet. And now with the shovel. Looking at Barry. Just a time. Ooh, straight to the throat. Into the ribs. Jabbing Jester. And Yvonne. Again, climbing onto the apron out of desperation. Has an eye on the target. Looking at a real big damage to Tristan. Jester jumping off. Jester got him. Jester got him. But in the back in a bad way. And now Jester is in control, taking Yvonne back into the ring. What does Jester have in mind? Ooh, big brain buster!
One. Two. Three.
Big move. We'll pick up the victory.
Five.
He doesn't move very much.
Six. Seven. Eight.
Up to eight.
Nine. He's to his feet.
Barely up in the nick of time to keep the match going. Picking him up! Reaper score! Out of desperation! Yvonne hit the finish of the fallen, but Jester rolling out to the ring and using the apron to get to his feet. Baseball slide straight to the rib. A unique move from Yvonne. Oh, he might have taken too much time to taunt! Ooh! On the outside!
One!
The tilt the wall!
Two! Three!
Yvonne almost had this match won!
Four!
But that could be all she wrote!
Five!
She reached the halfway of the count!
Six! Seven!
Yvonne put up a good fight!
Eight! Nine! Ten! That's it!
Tristan Jester has defeated
one of the
New Bomb.
Twisted Jester.
What a World Hardcore Title match. We are now officially on the halfway mark through this show, and what a boss fight it's been. Of the year and storm four times ever on a frostbite event. The unified Intercontinental Champion and defended against all challengers with an easy funding against Bobby J. Bobby J wanted this match. It's about a year ago. He never got his rematch, and to him, he only lost it due to an injury. So Bobby J, he is a proud wrestler, worked hard to own a championship match. Didn't just demand one, took his time, built himself back up, went back into the rankings, on a match for tonight. For all that hard work, we're out here tonight. A year ago, 5 days, we're at this event, in sports squad by taking the tag team championship. Focused so hard on Wilco's Mafia. Never got a chance to go for that title. And then with the Astro title, you get back at the Bulgarian King Rocky Jackson. But now it's time to focus on himself. Can the Roxa take the title here tonight?
The following match is scheduled for one fall, and it is for the Unified Intercontinental Championship. Defending and your Unified Intercontinental Champion, Storm. The challenger, Bobby J. All right, let's get this over with. Ring the bell.
Show respect between these two former tag team partners. In the past year, both have been part of Wilco's Mafia. Both know the end and understand how Rocky Jackson and the Barbarian mistreated them. Used them as lackeys. Goading him in. Instead of letting them be tag team partners. But before that, they were promoted by Blue Spade to be in the group. And that's where we will talk about Storm's deal thus far. Storm debuted, immediately picked by Blue Spade to join the Wolf Mafia. And he picked up the bigger man for a suplex. Not gonna happen. And so far in his young career, he's only competed on top shows like UFC Mania, like Heatwave. He's won the king of wrestling tournaments.
Storm, are you going to submit?
No!
Became a unified and intercontinental champion. But now on his first fight, can he close a fantastic debut year of life with a victory?
Storm, are you going to tell?
So far,
we need an answer.
The submission game has slowed down the speed of Storm, who's barely made it to the ropes.
Can you continue?
Yes.
Yeah? Alright.
A lot of damage has been done to that leg already. Bobby J. This size advantage definitely put some more advantage and more time into that submission. But those shots seem to have pissed off the champion, who for momentary got a adrenaline rush. So let's see if that leg would do damage in the long game. You can only see that Storm now is slowing back down a little bit. And look at that. That momentary is a little less speed. Okay, Bobby J is opening. Picking up and slamming the knee to the ground.
Are you gonna tap? You wanna submit?
No!
Okay. Screaming in pain. Trying to roll out of it. Rolling him up.
One!
Not getting the victory. Almost fell on one of those kicks.
Holy shit! He's a suplex Bobby J!
But again, damage on the leg is very clear. Having to use the ropes to stand. And taking just a more of a moment to get into the right position onto the ropes. Bottom rope, just to help him stand a little bit. You see those guys trying to play this a little slow.
Storm, are you going to submit?
Nah! I am not to show in his face that the Smith holds are holding when he's on the offensive. But you can see, look at this, on the defensive. He's riding in the chain.
No!
The submission holds are being very effective. Bobby J is very smart. Trying to roll out of it, but Bobby J keeping it in.
No!
Remember,
I'm gonna submit still.
It's a knee injury that cut Bobby J the championship. Very symbolic right here that Bobby is targeting the knees here tonight. If he knows it or not, is intentionally doing it or not. You know what? Going for a submission of his own.
You wanna?
Bobby J, you wanna submit?
Bobby's history of knee injuries.
Bobby J, which like this is the answer.
More painful.
Rope break.
Dome has learned a lot from Wilkes Mafia and now teaming with Silva. You can see that he could tell that Bobby J was about to make it to the hook, hit the knees straight onto the ground. For this match, he's going to be two wrestlers who respect one another. Dome trying to hype himself up. Fight to the green. Something he definitely learned from Silva. A resilient wrestler in their own right. Storm now going into his own a bit. Learning from Silva, learning from Wilkes Mafia, but also learning from himself. Learning from his experiences. Bailey kicked out in time. We almost saw a new unified Intercontinental Champion.
Can you continue, Storm?
Yeah.
Storm barely had any breath behind that.
Oh!
Bobby J definitely has the experience advantage and using it here tonight. Storm has never fought in this cold.
No!
Like Bobby has.
Are you gonna submit?
No!
Never had to fight through a nose injury like Bobby has. We have two Brazilian wrestlers. We ain't gonna give up. You see, Storm is a bit frazzled right here. He's trying to pick up a victory the best way he can. Straight to the back of the head. Stumbling around. Now he's trying to pick up the victory. Storm warning!
One, two, three! You're a winner! And still, the unified Intercontinental Champion, Storm.
What a way to end his year.
There you go.
A huge victory. It was really killing from both men. Moving back to extreme side things. Falls count anywhere.
Introducing first, the Fallen.
With a little bit of a twist, because if the Fallen loses, they must reveal what they want to use a chance of a lifetime on. They want it back. And my enemy, in other sense, has been hinting at it. Blue Spade related. I said that Blue Spade must go to him if they want to know the answer. Blue Spade hasn't been so much the agreeing of that. As the wind picks up here on a bit of cord, frostbite event. We know that Prince got involved with this feud last month, defending Blue Spade, and then eventually getting a match against the Fallen, which they would win. With little hope from Blue Spade. But if they lose tonight, high-risk briefcase or that briefcase will go to the hand of the fallen. Well, that's good tonight for both men in this matchup. Not only will the prizes be at stake, but the bodies will go through hell. Heal on Frostbite.
Fallen, this is going to end now!
That's it, Giant Gannon. I think he did lose. Prince Ellen trying to show a little bit of an overconfident vibe to the Fallen. Fallen wants none of it. Fallen knows what it's like to be in people's head. He knows he's in the head of the Prince. In this match, not taking long for Odie getting to the outside of the ring. Big Axe Hand is going to the upper back. Now it's him taking some time to turn. Not landing too good on those steps. And also hitting into the apron. Prince bringing the fight now to the Reaper, known as the Fallen.
Fallen. And the Prince, for goddamn sake! Get up, Fallen!
Prince is a proud member of Wolf
Coast. Get your ass up!
A good friend of Spade. But now, this ain't just about Spade versus Fallen. This is about Prince versus Fallen. Fallen said it himself. He's gotten close enough. Prince is now in his sight line. On his list of people to hurt. And he's holding him right now, grabbing him by the throat. He's getting up. The boss strikes to the neck. Fallen doesn't care about anyone's safety. And he's in a perfect match to do so. This match can go anywhere, can end anywhere, and anything goes. Taking the breath out of Prince very early on in this matchup. Straight on his face. Going, slowing down the pace. His time, making sure support will be part of his body. Slowly, methodically, stalking Prince. Choking the damn life out of him again. As I've said before tonight, it's going to be a big factor with this cold weather here at Frostbite. Let's talk about the history. The Fallen here at Frostbite has done some hardcore matches here, and another will be added as he's bringing this steel chair into the fight. He's pushing just at the first Frostbite. At the second Frostbite, not overlooked. Second Frostbite, the person we will later know as New Bomb, we placed the Fallen near the end of the match. We see the Fallen. Ooh! Super kick straight to the face! Steel chair! Hitting the head! We see the Fallen. Alright, buddy, let's just heal.
One! Two!
No new bomb. See in the left. The Fallen loses. He actually loses the steel on his own accord. But Chris Chandler has never fought at Frostbite. So, he's a little used to the cord. See, the wind knocking down that alleyway a little bit. But around the time Prince debuted, there was damn snow on the ground. So the winter cold and the wind does make a bit of a difference. But Prince has also experienced that a little bit too. So I don't think to the level that it is tonight. Flying up.
Oh, Jill! Holy fuck! There's his body as a weapon!
One, two,
and I'm surprised I didn't pick
God damn it.
The victory!
The ladder. Prince knows how to use those. That's how he won the highest briefcase in the first place. That won him his first title here in BYWE, the Tag Team Championship. Now setting it up in the corner. Calling Otisan to get to the feet a little bit. Or trying to take the briefcase. Instead, use it as a distraction for the Prince. Use Prince's own ego against him a little bit. And now Prince facing the steel. Closing him. Head bouncing off the steel.
Under.
That ain't gonna be enough. Prince still fighting. The way he's fighting, with the life being choked out of him. Vaughn has definitely been targeting the breathing of the Prince here tonight. They're going for it. Rolling fireman's carry.
One, two.
Somehow, someway, Prince kicks out. You can see it on his face. He is spent here tonight. Now just taunting him, looking him dead in the eye. Barely catching the foot. Pulling him into a clothesline. Aggressively dropping the fallen. Climbing the rope. Prince. Using a lot of his energy here. And using maybe the last of it to take the victory. On still kicking out.
Can't fall in.
And now he's trying to kick at the leg to get a victory.
That's mine.
Again using his ego against him. What a low blow. And this might be the end of the night of the Prince. And now, Vaughn picking him up like he was nothing, like he was 2 pounds. And Prince getting out of the Reaper skull. Straight onto the ladder. And falling. Laying down on an unpleasant lane. Just draped over that ladder, hitting straight to the ground. Now, Prince!
No!
Line him up. Stay on the target with that one. You can see the look on the side. He has something on his mind. And breathing heavily. The mask goes on. Full weight with the elbow. Now it's Prince. He's gonna use his own briefcase to secure the victory here tonight. Not gonna work. Ooh, straight to the head! You saw that briefcase used very effectively as Prince Chandler and Rufe and Rogue took home the Road Warrior Cup. But will the trophy be the only thing that he has up to tonight, being slammed very aggressively onto the ladder? Now Fallen eyeing the prize once again. You can see a little bit of the contracting. Anytime, anywhere, you can cash in. But now, the Fallen maybe having that briefcase. No ego right there. Straight to the head of the Fallen. And now, he's picking up the Fallen. Going, getting out of it. Taking him to the ground. Going up to the leg. Prince is not going to be able to walk after this one.
Please fall.
Begging ain't gonna work when you're facing the Fallen. We may be closing in on a victory. And maybe your high-risk briefcase holder. Getting out of it. Big suplex. May Prince can keep the briefcase and find out what the chance of a lifetime will be used for. Well, Bruce Bacon on the way with the victory.
No!
Not in the hand.
Not
yet.
Like this!
Prince setting up the ladder for something. Prince, you might be closing on the victory. But Fallen, running back now. Three, right. Dodging the clothesline. Prince, with a big one of his own, taking the Fallen off to his feet. Rocking, picture, perfect. Tying him up once again. Super kick!
It's over!
The Prince might be picking up a victory.
Bow down!
Throw throw! Straight on the ladder! That's definitely it!
1, 2, 3! Your winner! Boy.
Now the Fallen, lucky beer, but the chance of a lifetime will be useful by the end of the night.
Any time, any place, just remember that.
Anytime, anywhere, this will be your champion. On the tag team championship match of the evening.
The following match is a tag team title match. Introducing the first, the team of the coven, Oweet and Constant.
Very interesting to see that Constant is going to not use his hex form here tonight. We know this match means a lot to Elise, a very personal feud between these two teams.
And the BYWE Tag Team Champions Derek, Rocky Jackson,
and the Mountain.
The Mountain making the entrance. Turned it successfully. Defend the tag team championship. To close off this year. The last tag team match of 2021. You can only see by the way they handed those titles off, they want to get down
to business. Tag team championships. You ready? I don't give a fuck about you. Begin.
But let's get into why this is personal between these two teams. Hitting face first onto the ropes. You see Elise is very locked right there. And Constant Odie going for a tag. Rocky now looking to stop momentum. Ooh! Escaping. Rocky though was trying not to lose momentum and pull Constant into ring. But why is this personal, you ask? Elise believes the person who's been attacking her since August is Rocky Jackson. Little kick to the knee. Constant cost Rocky Jackson the World Hardcore title last month. Avoiding. Oh, tripping up Rocky Jackson. Constant trying to get under the skin of Rocky Jackson to start this matchup. Again, going for a dodge. Rocky Jackson can't cast Constant. Cock the boot. And again, almost tripped up Rocky Jackson. But the confidence has left the face of Constant, seeing that the Robin is in the ring trying to escape. Again, driving by the shoulder. And throwing Constant unceremoniously a couple of feet away. Now just stomping on the face. The momentum in do not like
Wait, you need to get him off.
They want to get down to business. They want to hurt their opponent. They want to get in, get out. Rocky Elise with Stair goes straight in the eye.
We got a tag.
Charge across the corner. Now elbow to Elise. Knee straight to the head of Constant. Constant is in a bad way. And the Mountain Man. The get in, get out style may prove effective. Going for the Mountain Man suplex.
One, two, two.
A two count already in this matchup. And now going for that submission hold. Constant could tap out.
What do you say, Constant?
Right here tonight.
Do you tap? Can you continue?
Bridging it over.
How can you hold? Are you good, Constant?
Constant looks like he's too much tapping.
Let me know.
Please, in on the nick of time and helping Constant to the corner.
Tag.
And Elise is in. Blackwood.
Tag.
Rocky desperately ran away. Didn't want none of Elise. No. Elise, going to do damage to both Mountain to make up for a little time. Very smart. Elise, using the ropes to your advantage. And Constant jumping at Rocky Jack at Bobby AM. And now all hell is breaking loose, grabbing her as she leaves the ring.
Alright. I need you guys back in the ring.
For
the match is inside the ring.
She's using the game momentum against the Barbarian. Picking
two,
at the leg. Making him fall
three,
off the apron to do more damage.
Four.
And now she is stuck here. Tonight, they were trying to go after the knees and the ankle of the Barbarian. He's very smart here tonight. And here comes Hex. Constant in! Elise!
We got a tap!
Made the tag. You saw the look on her face when you saw the spell is finally went through to Constant. And now it's time for the big boys to play. We're being with the clear size advantage. But the spell being passed onto Constant right now may be able to equal the strength just a little bit, just momentarily. You can see that it's getting to the psyche. for the Barbarian. Never facing someone like this. Headbutt. Barbarian still being able to go. Still on his feet. Going for the blow fist. Barbarian, he may have used the ropes to stay up, but he's still up. And I'll do damage to Rocky Jackson. Almost took himself damn out! That's what happens when an immovable force meets an unstoppable object. And now Rocky, going for the high game. Trying to use his event, but not being to knock out Constant. Went with straight uppercut, but Constant looking him dead in the eyes. Very smart Rocky, to try to stay on the attack. It's gonna take a lot to take this form of Constant out. Charging a swing! Taking him, cutting him in half.
Tap.
Now letting Lee's in. Do more damage.
Constant, I need you to get.
Kevin made a quick comeback in this matchup. With the posse season,
get him out the corner.
Tag team champions here tonight.
Two.
Elise and Constant,
three.
They have done it
out
before.
The quarter. Needs to get out the quarter.
Straight to the back of the head.
Pin!
One.
Okay, out of desperation, grabbing at the ankle. Elise's emotion getting the best of her, but managed to get out of the submission. Stomping on the ankles. Elise has a history of ankle injuries this year. And Rocky Jackson brutally capitalizing on that factor. I'm trying to get her over. Putting in the submission hold. Constant making the save.
Constant, I need you out the ring. Back out, you're not the legal man.
But Brian, trying to help out.
Both of you, get back to your corners. You're not the legal competitor.
Still not being able to knock out the Barbarian. Taking themselves out with a clothesline. Now these two are left in the ring. We will take home the tag team that cut the ring from Kevin Elise using the momentum of the rope. Getting elbows. The cutter. That could be all she wrote.
Two.
Elise barely kicking out in time. Rocky Jackson was too desperate. Did not put the full effect on the cutter. Oh no. Spell is worn off. But Lee's easy to make the tag. But the Coven won't win here tonight. Without the spell, could they win? Because now, there is no chance now Constant can match up with the Barbarian. You can see with the way Barbarian walked. With confidence.
Out of the corner. I am out of the...
But Constant has a few tricks in his sleeve, but he ain't gonna do that much damage. Now just grabbing Constant by his head and picking him up. To be all she wrote, Elise is still recovering from the cutter. But the one I think Constant's about to get in the moment is gonna be far worse. The Super Cutter!
One, two, three, and still, you're a BYWE Tag Team Champion, Rocky Jackson, and the Barbarian, the Mountain Man.
The emotion between both teams cost them at separate points. Elise couldn't stay focused. Rocky was very desperate at that moment. But in the end of the day, the Mountain Men were able to take the Tag Team Championships back with them. Carson looks very upset that you failed Elise.
Hello there. Seems like I can interrupt anybody's show these days. Isn't technology amazing? I'm sure you all know who I am, but if you don't, I'll remind you. My name is The Ref, and I am 50% owner of NEW. Quite frankly, at this point, I might as well just be 100% because Sane doesn't seem to care, and I don't think Victor King has come back from the buffet. I'm being told that NEW and Bywe? BYWE? I'm quite honestly not sure what it even stands for. Because to tell the truth, much like with that WWE roleplay fed in Texas, I only watch for Jake Matthews. So I can't really tell you much of what I know about the feud, but I do know that I brought the Rebellion into NEW to boost up our tag team division, you know, some actual talent. And then a bunch of the other roster followed along. We did need a B team. I mean, it increases our roster size, so I guess I can't complain too much. Makes a nice mid-card and pre-show. But hey, maybe there's some promising future talent in there as well. I'm just trying to figure out how there's any sort of challenge between BYWE versus NEW. You're telling me that the likes of Pepsi Man and the Neanderthal? The Barbarian? Or Insane Clown Jester or something like that? I'm not entirely sure if there's actually a farm maybe also on BYWE. Maybe that's gone now. There seem to be a lot of random animals running around. But I don't see how that's going to defeat the likes of Jake Matthews and Power Surge. Maybe Zero or the Twins. And of course that would be Sean Williams and Austin Adams, if they made it, or heck, even Sane. I think Sane was on the show for a bit too. Some weird booking went on there. But yeah, I guess there's a feud. It's probably going to be a burial, but hey, it'll bring you views. Why not piggyback off of NEW? We all know it's the superior show.
Listen, I don't care for excuses. Find out who let the ref interrupt our show. Listen, Eric Harris. I don't know why you want to interrupt our show, talk about a feud that we ended back at No Man's Land. You know, that show you used our name for views. I thought it was all over. I thought it was water under the bridge. You were letting our roster go there, and we were letting your guys come here, but clearly, you never liked that. Clearly, it was always the other owners making those decisions. But quite frankly, all of your guys that have came here have just been a pain in my neck. You want to talk about people treating people certain ways? Jake Matthews has given me a pyre driver more times than I have count. Justin Bassane and Rozo have done jack shit for all of you. So I don't think you guys are kind of helping us that much. But you want to talk about challenges. How about this? We put it to a test. Who is the better channel? NEW versus BYWE. You take all those people like Jake Matthews and Power Source, those people you claim are better than us, and we will put together our team, and why don't we put in a special stipulation since you think our channels filled with barn animals and morons, even though we've never had our universe end by jumping through a portal after a scary Halloween max keeps switching from face to face to face. But why don't we do something that you guys never have been able to do and face off inside a steel cage.
Do you know who I am? I am Blue Spade, your BYD champion. The best in BYWE history. Oh! Spencer, Nightfall, you took what belongs to me.
All smiles and know what it takes to fool this town.
We've been doing this before. Years ago, my force title defense of the BYWE Championship, and my force win was against you, Nightfall. Come, Frostbite. Your pain will be cured. Again, there's a reason why you haven't won the BYWE title. It's not because you didn't have the chance. It's because I kicked your ass. And I
I have faced him only once, and unfortunately he did beat me. But that was a different Nightfall. I am your reborn Nightmare. You're a new BYWE champion.
You were just Blue Spade in a different colored mask. I've seen you lose. But just to be sure then, I will put you down. And show everyone, especially you now, why I deserve to be your BYWE champion.
Frostbite is a show I debuted on. And it's the show I become a three-time
You can't beat me. No one has. And you are not going to be the one to do it.
I'm so confident. I'm unstoppable today. Unstoppable.
Your world title win will be a footnote in history.
This ain't a match. It's me burying a stupid career.
I don't think so. You're a born nightmare that's going to show why the painkiller is nothing special.
I'm unstoppable today, yeah. Unstoppable today. I'm unstoppable today.
The history between these two people are clear. But tonight, who will walk out with the BYWE Championship? Has the advantage here tonight, as he has never lost on a Frostbite event. And I'll remind you, after the first Frostbite BYWE Championship match is when the Pain Killer debuted in BYWE. Have only faced off once before as Painkiller versus Nightfall. Back at Battle Stations a few years ago for the BYWE Championship, where Spencer and Nightfall will fail to take the World Championship. Can he rewrite history? Can he beat the demons of his past and prove he is better now? That he deserves to be a world champion. With the odds stacked against him, can he be the force to pin the Pain Killer? Something that's never happened here in BYWE.
BYWE champion.
Back it up. Okay, this is a one-on-one match for the BYWE World Championship. In this corner, we have the challenger. He is the Pain Killer, Blue Spade. And in this corner, we have the reigning BYWE World Champion, Spencer Nightfall! You ready? You ready? Ring the bell!
Match has begun. With Nightfall being reborn, can he take the biggest victory of his career? Can he beat the Painkiller? Ooh, Ori starting off with a strong elbow. Nightfall's very strong. Ooh! And very smart to start off with the attack, but immediately Painkiller ate those strong elbows. Ooh, it is sending Nightfall's message. They have to do everything in his power to beat him here tonight. Ooh, straight to the top there. Painkiller is focused here tonight. Ooh, straight to the temple. Remember, the first time the Painkiller went away was because Bruce Bay knew. He's throwing him now. He knew. With the BYD title still existing and the Painkiller still wanting it, that no one would be safe. And Spencer Nightfall is not safe here tonight, but he's been here in the main event against the Painkiller.
Come on, he knows bring it back into the
what it takes to survive, but he does not know what it takes to beat him. He's gonna need to figure that out. He's up
one.
On the shoulder now.
Two.
Straight to the apron.
Bring it back to the ring. Three.
Painkiller's in sole control of this matchup.
Four. Five. Six.
What does Bruce say out of mind? Ooh. Taking out Nightfall.
I will cut you out. Come on. One. Two.
Straight to the shed.
Three.
Picking him up now. Again, slamming him onto the apron. Go for his elbow drop. Stay onto the rib.
One. One count.
One count, almost a two. Looking possibly for the punt kick. Nightfall getting away. Ooh! Taking off the Painkiller off his feet. Now it's Nightfall desperately on the attack. And he misses Pimple like often. And almost turning him inside out with that German suplex. And now we're gonna see the strength of Nightfall on display. Torture rack. Breaking the back.
One! One count!
Of the Painkiller, but not enough to get the victory. Barely even a one count. Ooh! But straight to the chin. Nightfall is going to use his speed in this matchup. What he's going to also have to use is his common factor to do adrenaline like when the
one count
is down and out, and it seems like all hope is lost. Like, all energy is spent out of nowhere. A burst of energy puts him back in the match. And with the late game match, if he can survive that long, that is, with the Painkiller could help him win the match. We know he's durable. We know he can kick ass. But if he can get that adrenaline rush, at the perfect time, he can save the matchup. But that's something Nightfall can't control. It just happened. So he's gonna have to try to survive and do what he's doing right here. Ooh!
Oh my god, he was just dropped on his back.
One! Two!
How the fuck did he get out? Just look at the Painkiller's face. I mean, he's surprised. I thought Nightfall's neck was damn broken. So today, Nightfall just had to do what he was doing now. Stay in this matchup.
Do you want to submit?
When he sees his opening, if he's spun, even if all is
exhausted and left his body. What do you need to do?
One!
What it takes to win. Ooh, riding the armor. Painkiller has a target right now, and it's the arm of Nightfall. Ooh, straight to the head. Ooh, pulling him inside out. Going for the victory.
One. One cap.
Oh, just trying to warm up. Get a quick victory. Now just holding on. Possibly out of desperation to keep momentum in his favor. And again, picking him up. Reversing it.
One.
Almost got the victory. But Nightfall still holding on. Picking him up. Ooh, huge slam. And Nightfall has an opening to try to take the victory here tonight. Climbing the ropes. Nightmare fuel. That's all.
One.
She won.
His foot is on the rope.
Barely got the rope. We barely got out of Nightfall's biggest move. Now going after the ankle.
One!
Thank God, too much time to recover from the nightmare fuel. Holy shit! He's in nowhere! The kaiju! Death trap! There he is! No escape! This is the move! That's about to be a kill of the victory!
He's on the rope!
A few years ago,
break the hole! One! Two! Three!
How about you?
Four!
Barely an inch.
I really disqualified.
There may be no escape from the kaiju death trap. But Painkiller has to follow the rules if he wants to win this matchup. Climb the ropes himself now. Ooh! An elbow drop of his own! This is his nightmare fuel!
One! Two!
And he's stunned that he did not get the victory! Off of his own move!
What?
Ooh! And then his own move! Blue in the face!
One! Two!
And Nightfall closing that count to a three count with the blue in the face.
Come on, get back into the ring.
Spade's own move. Ooh, got to be close on. Kick straight to the chin. Has Nightfall walked? Ooh, another one. And Painkiller stalking and now laughing.
Your pain will be over soon.
Then he's gonna end the pain of Nightfall. No, he's gonna go for a pie driver on the apron. Nightfall, stay out of it. Barely getting out of whatever Nightfall had in mind. Ooh, dodging a super kick. Wait, what's Nightfall doing? What's Nightfall doing? Ooh! Ooh! Oh, are you serious? Holy shit!
One!
Apron! Powerbomb! Jumping from the apron! How is Painkiller moving?
Three!
Barely!
Four!
Just moving! But Nightfall, he has his opening! He's gonna need a capitalize! Nightfall,
six.
This isn't safe, Nightfall. I wouldn't do this, Nightfall. It's a long way down. Oh! Nightfall putting caution to the side.
One.
To take home the BYD World Championship here tonight. Wellington Ricks himself.
Three.
For victory. To be the one to beat the Painkiller.
Four. Come on, get
here
back into
the ring.
Five.
Will this be it?
One. two.
Only a two count. Nightfall's going to put a little bit more into this matchup.
Oh, super kick.
Super kick.
Oh, use it. Momentum. For the super kick, bouncing him off the ropes.
Are you guys there to continue?
And at this position, hit a knee. But I think these two have spun everything. Left them to move.
Two.
Like the apron powerbomb. Jumping from the ring.
Three.
Another tackle. It's trying to motivate them to stay in this matchup.
Get back in there.
Stay out of this, Leonidas.
What the hell are you doing? I'm going to move you
up. What
are you doing? Stuart, get out of this business. You're telling me that right here is going to witness it.
And keeping outside interference. Double clothesline. Where are these two getting this adrenaline from? Caught him in the gut with a super kick. They're climbing the ropes now. Oh, Nightfall caught the painkiller. Head and neck going straight onto that knee. Oh, whale kick. Where the hell are these two getting this energy from? And Pinko barely taking momentum in his corner and barely moving. If Nightfall can keep this assault up, he may be the first one to beat the Painkiller. But unfortunately, the Painkiller has the momentum right now. He's the one standing. He's the one who's going to be in control of this match. A big chop. Big elbow. With his Painkiller, have in mind. Climbing the ropes now. This is not going to be a good move to do in the late game. This is going to do a lot of damage. Painkiller, looking for a suplex. Off the second rope. Taking out Nightfall. And I don't think there's going to be anything left.
One, two. Two count.
Nightfall, still in this. Barely kicking out, but he's kicking out, and as long as he does it, he throws him left, but it could be all she wants. Hook kick! No one can kick out of that. We have a new BYU champion.
One. Two.
What?
Two count.
What did I just see? Did Nightfall just kick out of the punt kick? I don't think I've ever seen that happen.
Let me kill your pain.
If he hits it again, it's all she wants. Nightfall barely dodged the punt kick. Left breaker. He's standing up on it. So glad that he moved at the nick of time for that punt kick. And now, Nightfall gonna take the victory with Nightmare Fuel! Painkiller now being the one to move at the nick of time! Bailey moved, but he did. Nightfall class hard into the mat from that far of a distance, from that height. And Painkiller has his opening. Punt kick! There's no way he can kick out two. New world champion.
One! Two! Two count.
Did Nightfall kick out of the... How is Nightfall still in this match? There's nothing left. Pinko is going to kill his pain, make him numb!
Come on, Nightfall!
Aggressively punch him, stomping his chest! Going to climb the ropes again, and out of desperation, pulled him off, and now hitting him with the kaiju! Death trap!
Do you want to submit?
If he can't pin him, maybe
Do you want to submit?
Tap him out. There you go. Bailey out. Lepo staying on the assault. Nightfall, if you can hit as you can be, the force to pin him.
One, two, three. That's it, ring the bell.
Nightfall, I just made history. He's retained
the
BYOE championship.
And still, BYOE world champion, Spencer Nightfall.
Nightfall is a force to beat the painkiller, proving he truly deserves to be BYWE World Champion. What a hell of a match. What a way to end the year.
You're a BYWE Champion.
Oh no. Bruce Spade is here. You must not be happy about losing the match. A sign of respect. And it looks like Bruce Wayne is calling it a night on the painkiller and taking a bow. Bruce Wayne solemnly walking away. I think this is goodbye from the person who has claimed to be the best in BYOE history. And I can't blame him. There's no way you can top a match like that.
Spade, Spade, Spade. You can lay your mats on the ground and you can have your little somber moment. But if you think you can walk off into the sunset now, then you are stupid as you look. Because as I said before, and as I will say again, you do not leave until I make you leave. And while I was planning to use my chance of a lifetime for BYWE Mania for a match against you, I cannot wait. Next month, at Mind Trap, it'll be you and me one more time. Your career on the line, and I will finally finish what I started back in 2020.